感谢主的恩典施恩带领我们这一次的灵恩布道会能够在教会里面来举行。
Thank God for His grace that He has allowed us to smoothly hold our ESC in person.
这一切都是神的恩典让我们三次都在线上举行，那这一次能够在教会里面来举行。
It is truly due to God's grace that we had three ESCLs online, and this is our first ESC in person.
让我们格外的感恩，能够来参加这一次的灵恩会。
We must have a thankful heart that we can come and attend this ESC.
在早祷会的时候，小弟想用一句的经文几节的经文跟大家一起来学习。
During this morning's prayer session, I would like to share a couple of verses.
我们请翻开提摩太后书的第二章二十二节。
Let's all turn to 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 22.
提摩太后书第二章第二十二节。
2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 22.
你要逃避少年的私欲，同那倾心祷告主的人，追求公义、信德、仁爱、和平。
Verse 22, flee also youthful lusts, but pursue righteousness, faith, love, peace with those who call on the Lord out of a pure heart.
这是使徒保罗来勉励年轻的传道人提摩太要逃避少年人的私欲。
This was what Timothy encouraged. This is what Paul encouraged Timothy to flee also youthful lusts.
他也勉励他要常常跟那些倾心祷告主的人追求。
And he also encouraged him to call on the Lord out of a pure heart.
这也是在勉励提摩太在他一生服事的历程之中呢，做一个倾心祷告主的人。
And this is also to encourage Timothy in his journey of servitude to live out a pure heart.
这也是在勉励着我们要做一个倾心祷告主的人。
And it is also to remind us to call and pray out of a pure heart.
我们都知道祷告对我们的信仰至关的重要。
We know that prayer is an essential part of our life of faith.
而祷告最重要的就是我们的内心。
And the most important part when we pray is our hearts.
主耶稣说，我们要用心灵和诚实来敬拜他。
The Lord said that we must worship in spirit and in truth.
可见我们在祷告的时候，在神的面前，神看着我们的内心来向他来祷告。
So when we pray, our Lord Jesus looks at our hearts.
我们的内心里面所思念的、所想的。主耶稣都知道。
And everything that we think, all our thoughts during our prayers, the Lord Jesus knows.
我们都知道，我们教会看重灵言的祷告胜过于悟性的祷告。
And we know that our church values praying in spirit rather more than praying in understanding.
并不是说悟性的祷告不重要。
It is not to say that prayer and understanding is not important.
而是灵言的祷告比悟性的祷告。常常是更有功效。
Rather, praying in spirit is more effective than praying in understanding.
因为在悟性祷告的时候，有时候我们在思念的所要祷告的词句就很难能够从我们的内心的深处来发出我们的祷告。
Because when we pray in understanding, it is very hard for us to use the words from the deepest parts of our hearts.
我们知道我们在祷告的时候必须要进到了灵里的深处，而不是在表面上面念着哈利路亚这样子。重要的是我们内心是不是进到了神的面前来。
We know that when we pray in spirit, we must pray into the deepest parts of the spirit, rather than just saying hallelujah repeatedly.
所以在犹大书里面也讲说我们要在圣灵里面祷告。
And in the book of Jude, it reminds us that we must pray in the Spirit.
也就是由圣灵来带领我们在祷告的内容。
Meaning that we ask the Holy Spirit to guide the content of our prayer.
那圣灵知道我们神的意思，所以能够把我们的心灵带到主耶稣的面前来。
Because the Spirit understands the will of God and it is able to bring us into the deepest parts of our prayer.
但是为什么需要清心的祷告呢？
But why must we pray with a pure heart?
我们来看一下马太福音第五章。
Let's take a look at Matthew chapter 5.
马太福音的第五章第八节，当主耶稣谈到了登山宝训其中的一幅。
In Matthew chapter 5, it talks about the blessings that Jesus gave on the Sermon on the Mount.
第五章的第八节，清心的人有福了，因为他们必得见神。
Verse 8, blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God.
不论是在平常的时候，或者是在祷告的时候，一个清心的人才能够得见神。
Whether it be in our daily lives or during in our prayers, only those who are pure in heart can see God.
所以我们来到神的面前，清心是非常的重要，我们才能够得见神。
So therefore, when we come in front of God, we must have a pure heart in order for us to see God.
但是我们要思想什么才是清心呢？
But let us think about what it means to be pure in heart.
这个清心也就是在讲的里面的心，我们里面的心是干净的，是纯洁的。
It talks about this heart which must be pure and clean.
我们来看一下诗篇的五十一篇第十节。
Let's take a look at Psalm chapter 51, verse 10.
诗篇的五十一篇。
Psalm chapter 51.
第十节。
Verse 10.
神啊，求你为我造清洁的心，使我里面重新有正直的灵。不要丢弃我，使我离开你的面，不要从我收回你的圣灵。
Verse 10, create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a steadfast spirit within me. 11, do not cast me away from your presence, and do not take your Holy Spirit from me.
这是先知拿单来提醒大卫所犯的罪以后，大卫认罪悔改所做的一首诗。
This is when Prophet Nathan went to David to remind him of his sin, and David wrote this psalm.
大卫那时候的心是忧伤痛悔的。
David, his heart was broken and contrite.
他知道他犯了，在神的面前他犯了非常严重的罪。
He knew the severity of the sin that he had committed.
他做这首的诗也是在诉说的他内心里面那种的内心原本那种的污秽感受到离神越来越远。
And David wrote this psalm with a heart of acknowledging the wrongdoing that he had committed.
他知道神知道他的罪。
He knew that God knew the sin that he had committed.
而这个罪会影响到他跟神之间的关系。
And this sin has caused him to have an effect on his relationship with God.
那这首诗呢，也可以说是大卫所做的一个祷告。
And we can say this psalm is also a prayer that David made to God.
因为在这首诗里面，他一直不断的祈求神。
Because in this prayer, he continually called on to the Lord.
而在第十节的地方，他说：“神啊，求你为我造清洁的心。”
And in verse 10, he asked God to create in him a clean heart.
他说他知道如果他这个罪没有得到神的赦免的话，他的祷告是永远没有办法能够到神的面前来。
He knew that if he could not receive forgiveness from God, then he can no longer come and pray in front of God.
因为他犯了罪。
Because of the sin he committed.
他害怕神不再听他的祷告。
And he was fearful that God would no longer heed his prayer.
我们知道我们的罪会阻挡着我们跟神之间的关系。
We know that our sins can often be a hindrance in between our relationship with God.
而在祷告之中，我们的内心、我们的良心责备我们。
And in our prayers, our conscience often guilts us.
阻挡我们的祷告。
And it can hinder us from praying to God.
所以我们在祷告的时候有一件很重要的事情，就是我们必须要常常的来省察我们自己的内心。
Therefore, a key aspect when we pray is that we must constantly examine our hearts.
为我们所犯的罪来求神来赦免，让我们的内心能够重新的得到洁净。
So that we can ask God for forgiveness and so that our hearts can become pure again.
这不只是包括了我们自己知道的罪。
And not only does this include the sins that we know that we have committed,
啊，也包括的隐而未现的罪，也就是我们不知道我们已经犯的罪。
But it also includes the sins that we have unknowingly committed.
我们来看诗篇的十九篇十二节。
Let's take a look at Psalm chapter 19, verse 12.
诗篇的十九篇第十二节。
Psalm chapter 19, verse 12.
谁能知道自己的过失呢？愿你赦免我隐而未现的过错。
Verse 12, who can understand his errors? Cleanse me from secret faults.
有时候我们人所犯的罪，我们并不知道我们犯的罪。
A lot of times when we make mistakes, we don't even know that we have committed them.
常常我们也忽略了这些的罪会影响我们跟神之间的关系。
And sometimes we do not think that these sins can affect us.
而这些的罪都是我们的内心里面、深处里面所发出来的，但是我们没有察觉。
However, sometimes these faults come out of our hearts, and because of that, we do not notice them.
譬如说，我们嫉妒别人。
For example, if we become jealous of someone,
我们看到别人的好，啊，那我们就内心发出了嫉妒。
For example, if we see the good in someone and out of our hearts, we have jealousy.
啊，或者是我们的心里面充满着贪心。
Or we become greedy.
啊，这些都是在我们的生活之中，啊，我们会去碰到的。当我们碰到的时候，我们内心犯了罪，但是我们没有去察觉到。
And these are all faults that we commit in our daily lives, and sometimes we do not know that we committed them.
所以我们在祷告的当中也很重要的，我们要为我们隐而未现的罪来向神来祷告。
Therefore, it is important for us in our prayers to pray for the faults that we have made in secret.
我们要求神让我们知道说我们这些隐而未现的罪，所以我们可以不要再犯。
We must ask God in prayer to reveal to us the faults that we have committed unknowingly and ask God to forgive us.
我们也求神来造我们一颗清洁的心，让我们在神的面前能够再次的有那种无愧的良心。
And we must also ask God to forgive our sins so that we can have a pure heart and have a clean heart.
而清心呢，另外的一个意思就是从比较字面上，就是心中没有任何的杂念。
Another understanding of having a pure heart is in our hearts we do not have any distracting thoughts.
哦，我们看英文就可以知道 pure heart， 就好像我们喝那个 pure water 一样，非常的清洁，非常的纯净的。
A pure heart can be similar to pure water where the water is very clean.
我们要喝水，我们一定喝清洁的水。
When we drink water, we always drink the purest water that we can find.
而我们来到神的面前的时候，我们也是应该是一个 pure heart， 是一个非常纯洁的、非常的没有杂念的一种心态来到主的面前。
And so when we come in front of God, we must also have a pure heart without any distracting thoughts.
哦，来献上那种没有杂念的祷告在主的面前。
And to offer up a prayer without distracting thoughts to God.
小弟到一些地方或者在教会里面，弟兄姐妹有时候会问到我，怎么样子祷告才能够专心？
Sometimes when I talk to brothers and sisters in other churches, people would ask, how is it that I can concentrate during prayer?
因为我们祷告不是三两分钟而已。
Because when we pray, it's not just 2 to 3 minutes.
在长时间的祷告的时候，有时候会分心。
Sometimes during a long prayer, we might get distracted.
所以大部分的弟兄姐妹在祷告的操练上面都会有这样子的问题：我的祷告怎么样子才能够专心呢
？Sometimes when we're training in prayer, we might ask ourselves, how is it that we can focus during the whole time?
其实保罗曾经教导的一句话，可以让我们深深来思念我们的祷告怎么样才能够专心。
Paul has once gave a teaching that can remind us how we can concentrate in prayer.
我们来看一下哥罗西书三章二节。
Let's take a look at Colossians chapter 3 verse 2.
这里虽然不是在教导的祷告的道理，但是这节的经文提醒着我们祷告的一个心态。
Here does not specifically talk about our teachings in prayer. However, it talks about our, it can reference our hearts or our attitude during prayer.
哥罗西书三章二节。
Colossians chapter 3 verse 2.
你们要思念上面的事，不要思念地上的事。
Verse 2, set your mind on things above, not on things of the earth.
如果我们的内心充满的这地上的事情的时候，我们跪下来祷告是绝对没有办法能够专心的。
If we set our minds on things of the earth and we pray, it is very hard for us to concentrate.
如果我们看了一部的电视剧然后过没多久我们跪下来祷告，我们在祷告的里面都还在想着那电视剧的内容。
See, if we watch a TV show and then immediately afterwards we kneel down to pray, you will know that it is very hard to concentrate.
我们看了一场非常精彩刺激的球赛，当我们跪下来祷告，你还在思念的那球赛的内容。
And if you watch a very exciting sports game and then you pray, might be very hard for you to concentrate as well.
或者你才刚刚跟别人吵架，你过没多久，你跪下来祷告，你还在想着那个人怎么样欺负你。
Or if you just had an argument with someone and then you pray right after, you might think about the things, the content of your argument.
相同的，如果我们过着一个非常的忙碌的生活，我们会常常的为这些忙碌的事情在我们的祷告当中来影响我们的心思意念。
Likewise, if you live a very busy life, then during your prayer, you might think about all the things that you might need to do.
所以我们的心思意念在祷告的时候，其实跟我们日常的生活是非常的有关系的。
Therefore, our thoughts during our prayers is closely related to what happens in our daily lives.
我们日常的生活之中所想的东西，会影响到我们在祷告的时候是否能够专心。
The things that happen in our daily lives may impact the way that we pray.
所以当我们读完圣经了以后，我们跪下去祷告的时候，我们会发觉我们很容易就进入到灵里的深处。
Therefore, if we read the Bible and then we pray right after, then we will be able to enter into the deepest parts in our prayer.
我们听完了一篇的讲道，再跪下去祷告，我们很容易就能够很专心的祷告。
And likewise, if we listen to a sermon and we kneel down to pray, then we will be able to concentrate in our prayers.
所以要让我们能够祷告非常的专心，能够清心的祷告，很重要的，跟我们的日常生活是脱不了关系的。
So if we want to be able to focus and have a pure heart when we pray, a lot of it is affected by how we live our daily lives.
这不是我们自己用自己的决心或心思意念一直控制着自己，我不要去想那些的事情，就能够很专心的祷告。
It is not something that we can control ourselves and determine not to think about the things of the world and then pray.
所以我们的生活，我们是过一个属灵的生活，我们的祷告常常能够达到神的面前。
Therefore, if we live a spiritual daily life, then we will be able to have our prayers reach to God.
所以我们一起来追求做一个清心祷告的人。
So let us all pursue a prayer, a life of prayer with a pure heart.
让我们的祷告功效能够常常的进入到灵里的深处。
So that our prayers can enter into the deepest parts of the spirit.
就是让我们过一个属灵的生活。
To live a spiritual life.
才能够真正做一个清心祷告的人。
To truly become someone who prays with a pure heart.
我们现在要一起跪下来祷告。
Now we're all going to kneel down and pray together.
我们知道现在目前可能开始在进行洗礼，我们也求神带领让这个洗礼能够非常的顺利。
We know that baptism is also happening right now as well, so let us all pray for the baptism sacrament.
我们也特别为这些新受洗的来祷告。
And let us also pray for those who are newly baptized.
让他们跟我们一样能够来走这条属灵的人生的道路，直到天家。
So that they can also walk with us on this journey of faith.
我们现在一起跪下来祷告。
Let's all kneel down and pray together.
也为我们接下来灵恩会还有圣餐礼一起来祷告。
And let's also pray for Holy Communion and foot washing.